I have often pondered, because of the difference in the experience that we talked about a moment ago, of the impulse back to Africa, the evocation of things African in the Doucet in your history, obviously, as African Americans, but which has been terribly, terribly fragmented. But you know, one of the things that I think is most important about that, and which is often unstated, which we did talk about yesterday in connection with the Native experience, is the fact that that really is an effort, if you will, to humanize, right, to humanize African Americans as kind of full-fledged
That's
people.
Right. Right. With a past.
With a past. Mm-hmm. With a past, with a human past, just like everybody else, as kind of full-dimension human beings, because there is a battle that both Native Americans and African Americans have had to do that has to do with a history in majority culture that sees us as something quite different from that.
Oh, for sure. Not just different, inferior.
Yes, subpar.
Subaltern is the word that scholars like to use.
Yes, I know.
It is so true that it's not simply difference.
Yeah.
It's a different in kind that denies the commonalities of all of us as human beings.
Sometimes I'm tempted to tell people, well, yes, Indians are. We laugh, we cry, we're happy, we're sad. You know, we're just human. It's so ironic because in Cheyenne, for example, the word for us, what we call ourselves in our language, is statistas, and that simply means human being. And yet, you know, that's what we really, really were not for so terribly long. And it does relate to this subject of love that is the organizing principle here. Because to me, one of the advantages of finally accepting yourself as human, as part of a group of people who are human, is a capacity to love yourself, not in any inappropriate way or egocentric way, but just accepting yourself, because that's actually what gives you the ability, the capacity to project the love outward.
That's right.
Too. And so this notion of art, visual art, as an expression of us that humanizes us, to the extent it can accomplish that, it has done a wonderful thing that relates directly to the concept of our capacity to love ourselves and love others.